The first large new government building erected by the National Socialists was the Reich Ministry of Aviation in front of you. The architect Ernst Sagebiel created this monumental structure with around 2,000 offices in 1935-36. The short construction period was used for propaganda purposes to put the new system on display. The building complex, structured around several courtyards with 56,000 square metres of usable space, used both reinforced concrete and steel frame construction. A striking structural feature was the matching rows of windows, which extended with sharp edges from the smooth shell limestone facade, giving the building an objective and functional aesthetic. The Nazi state, as commissioner, made sure to present themselves. Two stately Reich eagles framed the entrance to the courtyard, and the facade was also decorated with swastikas. Other reliefs showed military symbols such as the Iron Cross, as well as the Pour le Mérite, the highest German order of merit. This was an allusion to the head of the house, Hermann Göring. Among the leaders of the Third Reich, this extrovert and bon vivant was a popular figure with the public. Besides his sociable nature, this was also due to the adventurous life he had led. At 12, his father sent him to a military academy. In 1914, he first went to the front as an infantryman, but soon switched to the Air Force. He became a successful fighter pilot in World War I, was awarded the Pour le Mérite, and became well known to the public. After the peace treaty, the conservative militarist fundamentally rejected the Weimar Republic. This rejection was made stronger by the Treaty of Versailles, which affected the pilot Göring in a very personal way, because it was forbidden for the Republic to maintain an air force, and also civil aviation was greatly hindered. He therefore moved to Scandinavia, where he got by as a pilot and representative of German aircraft companies. After he had returned to Germany, he met Hitler in Munich and joined the Nazi Party. In 1923, he participated in the Hitler Ludendorff coup and, after its suppression, was able to flee abroad, severely wounded. Amnesty, granted by Reich President Hindenburg, allowed the rebel to return home without penalty. In 1928, this self-professed enemy of Parliament became a delegate in the Reichstag, and then, in August 1932, even became its president. After the accession to power, Göring set himself up as second-in-command in the Nazi hierarchy. As the provisional Prussian Minister of the Interior and later Minister-President, he had direct access to the police, which he rebuilt into a terror apparatus. Göring also secured himself a key position in the military sector as Reich Aviation Minister. By breaching the Treaty of Versailles, he was responsible for building up the Air Force, at first in secret and later officially. In his ministry, crucial elements of remilitarization and rearmament were mixed together. In 1937, the first glimpse of the immense destructive power of the new German bombers was shown to the world when, in the Spanish Civil War, the Legion Condor almost completely destroyed the Basque city Guernica. Many more air raids on European cities followed during World War II, including the infamous bombing of Warsaw and Rotterdam. The opponents' response came in May 1940. The Royal Air Force made their first attacks on German cities and in August bombed Berlin for the first time. The Battle of Britain soured Hitler towards Göring, whose plan to force Britain to surrender with this air campaign had completely failed. Instead, there was a great loss of life and machines. As a result, Göring lost influence in Nazi leadership. Yet, even after the Stalingrad disaster in 1943, for which Hitler made him hold a share of the responsibility, Göring still maintained control of the Air Force. However, he was rarely seen at the ministry. He often stayed at his estate, Karenhall, where he lived in the lap of luxury like some Baroque prince, and preferred to pursue the post of professional huntsman of the Reich. He also liked to play with model trains, built a collection of stolen and looted art, and increasingly fell into drug use. At the same time, since German fighter squadrons and anti-aircraft artillery had lost control of their own airspace, Germany's cities were experiencing heavy bombing by the Allied forces. This photograph shows one of the last appearances of Göring and Hitler together at the beginning of April 1945, before Göring defected to Obersalzberg. Hitler had him arrested there as a traitor to the SS 1 week before his suicide. The Americans arrested Göring again, and he was sentenced to death in the Nuremberg trial. In October 1946, he escaped execution by ingesting cyanide. While the neighbouring area lay in ruins, the Ministry of Aviation made it through the Second World War with amazingly little damage. The Soviet military administration moved in next. To denazify the surface of the building, imperial eagles, Nazi emblems and sculptures with a military subject were removed. On October 7, 1949, the East German state was founded in the Great Hall. During the modernisation of the building from 1996 to 2000, the multi-layered history of today's Federal Ministry of Finance was thoroughly taken into account. In recent years, film directors have repeatedly used this place as a backdrop for films about National Socialism. Do you like this video clip? Please subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.